Good morning, everyone. Myself K. Kiran Kumar, working as lecturer in Electronics and Communication Engineering section. Presently working at Jawaharlal Nehru Government Polytechnic, Hyderabad. Today I am going to discuss a topic in analog communication systems. It is currently in third semester in C18 curriculum. So in the last class we have discussed the design of several types of antennas like dish antenna, Yagi-Uda antenna, helical antenna and loop antennas, and we have seen some examples also. Now in the today's class we are going to discuss some details about the transmission lines. Right. Coming to the objectives of the today's topic, upon completion of this topic you will able to describe different types of transmission lines. Then we will see the functions of the transmission line. Then what is the electrical equivalent of a transmission line, we will see. So these are the objectives of the today's class. First we will discuss what is mean by a transmission line. So up to now, when you are discussing the modulation, all those things, so that we majorly used in the wireless communication. So already told, in communication, or the communication will be established based on the channel. That channel may be two types. One is called as wired channel, where a physical medium will be present between transmitter and receiver, or source or destination. That type of channel is called as wired medium or wired channel. So that best example for that one is, so transmission line A line is an example for a wired medium or a physical medium connecting between transmitter and receiver. Similarly, coaxial cable, optical fiber cable. So all these are the example for different channels, different mediums used in the wired communication. Whereas in the wireless communication, we will use a antenna. So that is an element. One is used at the transmitting end, another will be used at the receiving end. With help of these two things, there is no physical medium between the transmission and reception, as we discussed in the modulation, that is analog modulations, that is amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, all those things we have seen. Now we will see, so this is the best example for wide medium. Therefore, first we will see what is mean by transmission line, then we will see some details. So these transmission lines are interconnecting medium or interconnecting channel that convey electromagnetic energy from one point to another point, that is from source to the destination. Now we will see what is a transmission line we will do. This is the definition. So here it convey information. So this information may be several types. Example, speech, music signal, picture signal, video signal, audio signal, all those things, and also data. So that will be used in the data communication, that is computer to computer. And all these information will be in the form of electromagnetic energy, that is RF energy, that is radio frequency energy. And it will transmit it to a required distance, means so the transmission of the signal in the form of EM wave to a required distance. Now we just see a practical example for this one. So maybe you have seen electrical power transmission. That is, electrical power transmission means, so generally we are using the electrical power in our homes. That signal, that electrical power will come from some power stations like thermal power station, nuclear power plants, or hydro power plants. That is, which will be where power will be generated from water. This means from that places finally it will come to the our home, means for different applications. So here this power will be transmitted by using a some electrical power transmission. Maybe you have seen we have seen so many places. Here we are using some open conducting wires. So here we are using the conductor wires which are open, not a closed one. With help of this one we are transmitting the electrical power. So that is the best example for a transmission line. So therefore the medium for electrical power transmission is open conductor cables. And similarly, another best example for this transmission line is, maybe you have seen telephone signals are transmitted from one place to other place. This telephone means landline telephone, maybe you have seen. So means by using a telephone cables or telephone wires, so which are generally in black color, from our home to the nearest exchange or local exchange we will say, so that will be connected by using a pair of wires, maybe you have seen. So that is also example for a transmission line. So here we will use a two wire system. So means by using two wires we are transmitting the signal from subscriber to the telephone exchange. So this is also example for a transmission line, because by using here in this example also we are using a physical medium or a group of two wires to convey the voice signal or to transmit the voice signal. And similarly, another best example is, maybe you are using the TV transmission, that is which will be used for receiving the television signal. So maybe you have seen the medium where television signals are brought to your house or brought to your home by using a coaxial cable. So this is also one type of transmission line. But nowadays we are using a broadband connection, means by using a one wire or one transmission line we are able to receive telephone calls, internet and TV simultaneously by using a broadband connection. So that may uses optical fiber cable. So maybe you know the optical fiber cable, so which will offer more bandwidth compared to the normal wires. Maybe you know the optical fiber cable means this cable is made with a glass type of material, or glass or plastic one, where the signals will be transmitted in the form of optical signal or in the form of light. We'll see that details in the communications next topics. So this is also example for transmission line. So what is the examples we discuss? All these are the example for a different transmission lines. So only remember, in the transmission means by using a physical medium we are doing the communication. So these are the some practical examples. Now we are seeing the different types of transmission lines. So this picture will show you the first example of the transmission line, whatever we told, that is the transmission line used to carry the electrical power. Maybe you have seen these things. So generally, so these towers or these structures will be used for high power ratings of powers. High power rating, that is generally in kilovolts, where current will be very high and power also high. At that places we are using generally this type of structures. So this is one example for transmission line. So this is called as open wire lines, because in this one we are not losing that one, all the lines are opened in the air and having some spacing between the wires to prevent the short circuit. Next example is coaxial cable. Maybe you have seen this will be used generally for receiving the TV signals to the home. This we look at that one. So this is the structure of a coaxial cable where it will contain two or more layers, as you see in the diagram. The first one, inner one, most, which will carry the information in the form of current or voltage. So that is made with copper. Maybe you are seeing the figure. Above the copper wire there is a insulation which is in the black color. Then above that one there is a copper mesh, and finally to cover all these three we are taking one more insulation, that is called as outer layer. So this is the structure of a coaxial cable. So one copper wire which will be used to carry the information in the form of electrical signals. Above that one there is a insulation, above that one there is a copper mesh which will be used for grounding, and for all this one it will be covered with one more insulation, that is called as outside insulation, which will provide the shielding or which will provide the strength for the structure. Generally this will be very thick, the outer layer. So this is the structure of a coil. This is also example for transmission line. So this is the structure, and this will be the second diagram will it will be look like this. So this is a coaxial cable. There is two side, that is called a connectors, or we can say couplers, which will be used to join the two ends, two points are from source to the destination. Right, now we'll see next one. So waveguide. So this is also a example for transmission line. So these waveguides are generally used for microwave applications. So means, so generally these structures are these transmission lines used for a used at high frequency applications. Right, this now we can just first one see this one. So since it is in the form of cylinder, therefore it is called a cylindrical waveguide. And the next figure, it is called as rectangular waveguide because the dimensions of that device are in the dimensions of this element is in rectangular shape. That's why it is called as rectangular waveguide. Similarly there are square waveguides because it is in the square waveform. So this is also one of the type of transmission light. Next one, next as we told, optical fiber cable, so which will be used to carry the information in the form of light. So this fiber optical cable construction, look at that one. So here also it will contain two or three or four major layers. The first inside is called as core. So generally this core may be made with glass or plastic or fiber. So where light signal will passes between the two points. Above that one there is a insulation called as cladding. Next one, above that one there is a coating, insulating coating, and above that one we are having a strengthening fibers, so which will provide the mechanical strength to the core material. Because so generally this core material used in the fiber optical cable is very very thin, or it is very very sharp, means the dimension or thickness of that core material is very very small. So therefore to provide the mechanical strength for that one we are using the strengthening fibers. And finally, and all these will be strengthened by a outer layer called as cable jacket, where the dimensions of this one is more or large. So this is the structure of the optical fiber cable. It will look like a coaxial cable, but coaxial cable offers less bandwidth, whereas optical fiber offers more bandwidth, means which will carry more information or more amount of information. So these are the different types of transmission line. One is open wire lines used for electrical power, and then waveguides, coaxial cable, copper wires, and then optical fiber cable. So these are the different example for a transmission lines. Right, now we'll see applications of transmission lines. As we discuss, transmission line acts like a connection or a connection link between transmitter and antenna, or antenna and receiver. So maybe you have seen in the transmitter it will do the several functions, or it will contain several blocks like oscillator, message signal, modulator, amplifiers, power amplifiers, and finally these are connected to the transmitting antenna. So means all these elements are connected by using a physical medium or by using a transmission line. Similarly, in the case of receiver, after receiving the signal from the channel, the receiving antenna will be connected to the further processing, as we discussed in the receiver. And all these functions and all these devices and all these elements in the receiver are connected by a physical medium, where that physical medium is called as transmission line. So that is the first application of the transmission line. Then it is used to provide phase shifts and also time delays, and which will be used for impedance matching. As we told, impedance matching means whenever source is matched with the load impedance, therefore maximum power will be transmitted from source to the load according to the maximum power transfer theorem. Therefore the best application of the transmission lines, this will be used for impedance matching between the two elements or two devices, and it will also use it to provide phase shift and time delay. Then so here one more application of the transmission line is the transmission length of a certain length, that is, so generally the transmission line length will be measured in lambdas. So certain length of the means lambda by 4 or lambda by 2, lambda by 8 means 1 by 4th of the wavelength, or 1 by 2 of the wavelength, or 1 by lambda, 2 lambda. So this is called as certain length of a transmission line. These are different lengths of the transmission line used as a filter, means it will act like a filter based on the length of the transmission line. Then it will act like a tuned circuit. This may be used in a receiver or transmitter. Next, similarly, so maybe transmission line means it is a wire, means that wire may be open or short on the other end. Maybe because a transmission line or a wire will be having two sides. One side, if it is connected to source, other side maybe if it is not connected to anyone, we can say it is an open transmission line. Whenever it is connected to a load, then we can say it is connected to the load. Maybe that load may be short circuit, means so based on that one, the open ended transmission line means the transmission line where other end will be open. The transmission line acts like a antenna, means first end will be connected to the some source or some device, another end will be it is open, and this transmission line will acts like a antenna. So this is also application of a transmission line. So these are the different applications of a transmission line. Now just we'll see the behavior of a transmission line. Now we'll see how the transmission line will carry the information. We'll see now. When the current is sent through a long line of two parallel uniform conductors, then magnetic field will be created around the conductors, and therefore there will be a voltage drop or EMF. So that is whenever current is passed through a transmission lines, so which will be having two conducting wires with uniform conductivity, means the wires is having the uniform, means everywhere the conductivity will be same throughout the length, and these two wires are parallel to each other. So here, so transmission line having two parallel uniform conductors. Whenever current is passed through this one, there is a magnetic field will be developed across the conducting wires, therefore it will form EM wave, that is EM energy, that is electromagnetic energy. Therefore EMF or voltage will be induced according to the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. So this is the basic principle of a transmission line. So here, because of or presence of the magnetic field, so this which is proportional to the current flowing through the transmission line indicates that the line is having a series inductance. And similarly, the voltage drops across the transmission line indicates that it has a series resistance represented by R. Means, so because of these properties, we can say the transmission line is having impedance, resistance as well as inductance. Next one, since these two conducting wires are close with each other separated by insulating medium, because whenever we will take two wires are parallel, means in the middle of the conducting wires air will be present, and this air will acts like a dielectric material or insulating material. Therefore according to the capacitor formula, means capacitor will be formed whenever two conductors are separated by a dielectric medium or insulating medium, it will form a capacitor. Therefore according to that principle, we can say the transmission line is having a capacitance between them, that is represented with capital C. Similarly, because of the leakage of the current through the dielectric material or insulating materials, it will form a shunt conductance, that is represented with G. Therefore the transmission line is having inductance, resistance, capacitance and conductance. Therefore it is having all these parameters. Therefore generally R and L are in series, we are taking in series values, that is series resistance, series inductance, and C and G are in shunt values, that is shunt capacitance, shunt conductance. So these will be exist in any transmission line, and the values of R, L, C and G are uniformly distributed along the length of the transmission line. Means all the values of this one are same throughout the transmission line. Means everywhere on the transmission line or at any length, it will be uniform. It will be same throughout the material or throughout the transmission line. And these cannot be physically separable. Means all these will be exist in any given transmission line. R means series resistance, L means series inductance, C means shunt capacitance, and G means shunt conductance. And these will be uniform throughout the transmission line and all cannot be separable. This is one of the important property of a transmission line. So this is about the behavior of a transmission line. And these generally, these values, that is R, L, C, G, measured in per kilometer, means resistance value generally the units are ohms, but resistance of a transmission line will be measured ohms per kilometer. And similarly, inductance of a transmission line measured in Henry's per kilometer. And similarly, for capacitance, it will be measured for a transmission line in terms of farads per kilometer. And finally, and conductance will be, which will be opposite to the resistance, therefore units are mhos. Therefore, for a transmission line, the units are mhos per kilometer. So these are the units for all the parameters of a transmission line. So this is about the properties or behavior of a given transmission line. So now if you summarize these things, so here up to now we are discussed about different types of transmission lines, different like that is open wire lines, two wire coaxial cable, after optical fiber cable, and then we have seen different uses of these transmission lines, and then finally we have seen behavior of the transmission lines, means what is the basic principle and the different parameters of a transmission line we have seen. So this is about the summary of this topic. And finally we this equivalent circuit of the transmission line we will see in the next topic. Based on this one, try to answer these questions. Right, just see the question. The type of the transmission line used to receive telephone calls, comma, internet and TV signals simultaneously is, just try to check the answer. Two wire line, coaxial cable and optical fiber cable. So answer will be optical fiber cable, because from the given question, the transmission line will carry telephone lines, internet, TV signal simultaneously, which requires more bandwidth. Therefore, suitable answer for that one is optical fiber cable. We can say it is a broadband connection. Therefore, option will be C. Final D option will be single wire. So no need to tell that one, answer will be C. Next one, series inductance in a equivalent circuit of a transmission line is due to, just see this one also directly. So see the options. First option is presence of magnetic field around the line proportional to the current flowing through it. Second option, voltage drop across the line. Option C, two conducting wires separated by a dielectric medium. And D will be leakage current through the dielectric medium. So as we told, inductance will be due to magnetic field around the transmission line. So which is proportional to the current flowing through the conducting wires. Therefore, option will be A. Right. Just some of the important questions from this topic is, so what is a transmission line? What are the different types of a transmission lines? Draw the equivalent circuit of a transmission line. Now we'll see what is the equivalent circuit of a transmission line. As we discuss, so this is the practical figure of a which will show you the details of a coaxial cable in the details, which is having a copper wire that is represented with a D, and above that one there is some plastic that is in the white color. So in the figure it is represented with C, that is a insulator. Above that one there is a copper shield that will be represented with B. Finally, there is a insulating material, so which is in the black color, represented with A. So this is the structure of a coaxial cable. So as we told, A is the outer plastic sheath which will cover the total three parts, and B will be the copper screen or copper sheet, we can say copper sheet, and C will be the inner dielectric insulator, and finally D will be the copper core. Right, so this is another transmission line which is called as twin lead. So means that device or that component will be used to connect the two wires, as you are looking in the diagram. Now we'll see the electrical equivalent circuit of a transmission. As we discussed, now the transmission line is having uniform resistance, inductance, capacitance and conductance. And all these for a transmission lines, as we told, all these values are same throughout the transmission line, that is said to be uniform. So based on the behavior of the transmission line, the equivalent circuit will be given like this. If you look at the transmission lines, if you take any part of the transmission line or any section of the transmission lines, throughout the lines it is having four parameters. That is, as you look at the diagram, it has series resistance, therefore it is connected in series. Then it is having inductance, which is also series one, that's why it is drawn in the series. Finally, capacitance will be, and conductance will be shunt values. Therefore, G and C are in shunt with the shunt in the circuit diagram. And here, if you look at that one, so these are drawn three times, means here throughout the transmission line all the values are same, means every part of the transmission lines these values are not separable, or these parameters are not separable, and all are uniform. So therefore this is the equivalent circuit of a transmission line, means with this one we can say R and L values are series and G and C values are shunt or parallel to the circuit. This is the simple equivalent circuit, and now we'll see the parameters, some more details. And these resistance, inductance, capacitance and conductance are called as primary constants of a transmission lines. As we told, Rs is the series resistance and it will be measured in ohms per kilometer of a transmission line. Similarly, L is the series inductance and it is measured in Henry's per kilometer. Similarly, C is the shunt capacitance measured in Farad's per kilometer. And similarly, G is called as shunt conductance measured in mho's per kilometer. So these are the different parameters and their respective units. And here these primary constants are generally vary with the transmission lines, vary with the frequency of the transmission line. But in transmission line or in transmission line theory, they are assumed to be constant, means these values are said to be constant with respect to the frequency, because as the frequency changes, the lambda, that is wavelength of a transmission line, also changes. Therefore, according to this one, the values of or the parameters of a transmission line will be changes, but these values are assumed to be constant. And these are now, as we told, the units for R, L, G, C are like this. That is, L is units are Henry's per meter or kilometer. C will be units are Farad per meter or kilometer. So for a given unit length, means for a small length, generally inductance will be having the units for Henry's per meters. Similarly, C, that is for unit length, is Farad per meter. Like that, for resistance is ohms per meter. Similarly, for G, that is mho's per meter. And these values are with respect to your unit length. Right. So therefore, we will make some more analysis based on the equivalent circuit of a transmission line. As we seen, from the equivalent circuit of the transmission line, the series impedance and shunt admittance of a transmission line for a unit length will be given as, maybe you have seen in the networks or in the basic network analysis, the series impedance will be having the two components, that is resistance and inductance. Therefore, the total series impedance, that is represented with capital Z, or you are seeing, that will be given as R plus reactance of the inductance. So that is X. So where, as you know, the basic fundamental rule, reactance of the inductance will be given as 2 pi into F into L, where F is the frequency and L is the inductance. And this 2 pi Fn can be written as omega. Therefore, for the given transmission line, therefore, series impedance will be equal to R plus XL or R plus J omega L, where this J term will represent imaginary term. And similarly, output admittance, so that is having the two components or two parameters, that is one is capacitance, one is conductance. Therefore, whenever we are taking the capacitance, we have to take the reactance of the capacitance, that is represented with XC, where XC is given by XC is 1 by J omega, 1 by omega C. Therefore, the total admittance, that is shunt admittance, that is represented with Y, will be equal to G plus 1 by G plus J omega C, where there is this J term will represent imaginary terms. So these are called as, these are from the transmission line parameters. one is Z, another one will be Y. Z is called as series impedance and Y is called as shunt admittance. Right, now we'll see next parameters of a transmission line, that is the characteristics impedance, that is represented with Z naught, and propagation constant, that is represented with capital P, are called as secondary constants of a transmission line. These two are called as secondary constants of a transmission line. Now, for a given transmission line, the input impedance will be depends upon several factors like type of the line and length of the line and transmission load. So these are the various factors where input impedance will depends. Now just we'll discuss what is mean by secondary constants, that is characteristic impedance represented with Z naught, and similarly propagation constant, that is represented with P. We'll see the definitions and some more details of this one. As we are finished primary constant, now we are seeing the secondary constants of a transmission line. First pair secondary constant is Z naught, and it is defined as the impedance measured at the input of a transmission line whose length will be infinity. Means if the length of the transmission line infinity, the input impedance or the impedance present at the input terminals is called as Z naught, that is called as characteristics impedance for a given transmission line. And this characteristics impedance is also called as surge impedance. And these characteristics impedance determined by characteristics of a transmission line for unit length. And this will be not affected by the physical length of the transmission line. Means this value will be depends upon the characteristics of a transmission line. For any transmission line, the characteristics impedance is given by, so just look at the formula, that is Z naught is given by Z by Y, that is square root of Z by Y, where Z is called as series impedance and Y is called as shunt admittance of a transmission line. As we told, Z will be given as R plus J omega L and Y will be given as G plus J omega C. Therefore, Z naught is given as square root of R plus J omega L divided by G plus J omega C. So this is the formula for characteristics impedance of a transmission line. Here we'll see some cases, we'll discuss what is this one. For a lossless line, means for the transmission line where losses will be zero, where losses are not present. Whenever losses are not present, means R value will be 0 and G value will be 0. Just substitute the values in this above equation. If you substitute that values, therefore Z naught becomes square root of J omega L by J omega C. So omega will cancel. Therefore Z naught becomes square root of L by C. Means for a lossless transmission line, the characteristic impedance will be equal to square root of L by C values. Therefore, so this is about the formulas related to the characteristic impedance. So from this equation we can say this characteristic impedance neither depends upon the length of the line nor on the nor on the type of the terminating load. Means it will not depends upon the load and it will not depends upon the length. And this will be determined by the characteristics of the line for unit length. That is, it will depends upon R, L, G and C values. And this characteristics impedance physically found by size of the conductor and spacing of the conductor and dielectric constant of the insulation. So based on this one, we will find out the characteristics impedance physically. Right. So here we will see some practical values of a for a different transmission lines. That is, the characteristics impedance of a coaxial cable is given by, that is, Z0 equal to 138 by root K into log 10, that is log base 10 capital D by small d. So where this K is called as dielectric constant of the insulation, capital D is called as inner diameter of the outer conductor of the coaxial cable, and D will be the diameter of the inner conductor. So this is the formula to calculate the characteristics impedance of a coaxial cable. So this is the structure of the coaxial. As we see in the structure of the coaxial cable in the beginning just now, so it has two wires. One inner one is called as inner wire or inner core, and above that one there is a conducting which will be used for grounding, that is also conductor, that diameter is having capital D. Right, here the characteristic impedance of a cables which are used for radio transmitter and communication receiver, the value will be 50 ohms. Similarly, for cable television and TV antenna, the field lines or the transmission lines is having the impedance, characteristics impedance of 75 ohms. And similarly, for computer cables, that will be the cables used for computer, having the characteristics impedance of 93 ohms. And similarly, for open wire lines, the characteristics impedance will be high, that is 600 ohms to 900 ohms. The TV twin lead cable having the characteristics impedance of 300 ohms. Similarly, we will see last one, the characteristic impedance for a parallel wire line. So parallel wire line means the transmission line where it is having two wires separated with a dielectric medium or insulator. For that type of construction, the characteristic impedance is given by 276 divided by root K into log capital S by small r. Here, where K is called as dielectric constant of the insulator and S is called as center to center spacing between the two conductors. Next one, R will be smaller will be the radius of the each conductor, because we are using the two wires of same length, same dimensions. And so here, if it is one second. So this is not D, this is S. So this is the generalized formula for characteristic impedance of a parallel wire line. If you take air as the medium or dielectric, where K value will be 1, therefore Z0 If substitute the k value of 1 on the above equation, it becomes 276 log of s by r or d by r. So where s or d will be the distance between the two wires. So this is about the characteristic impedance for a practical transmission lines. So with this one, we'll stop the class. Just we will summarize whatever we told. So up to now, we have discussed about what is mean by transmission line, different types of transmission line, applications of transmission lines. Then we have seen behavior or working principle of a transmission line. Then we have seen primary constants of a transmission line. Then we have seen secondary constants of a transmission line, that is characteristic impedance and propagation constant. So in the next coming session, we will see the what is mean by a propagation constant, how to measure that one, and propagation constant in more details we will see in the next topic. So with this one, we'll stop the class. Thank you very much.